Brett G. Hope you guys are all having an amazing Monday. Did you know that there's only 12 days left until Christmas? If you're not in the Christmas spirit yet, you need to pause this video, blast some Christmas music, go make yourself some hot chocolate, throw in a Christmas movie, and just kick back and take it easy! Or you can put your trust into Big Dick Dave because this video will get you in the Christmas spirit. I promise. I'm full blown in the Christmas spirit already. Like, I've been Christmas shopping since Black Friday. I listen to Christmas music every single day. My tree is up. I got this freaking pine Christmas tree candle going right now because it just smells so amazing. I even got a Santa hat right here, but I'm not gonna wear it because it makes me like hot and warm, and then I start to sweat a lot, and then hives start showing up on my face, and it's just not a good look. So yeah, we're gonna keep it simple, but there's a hat in here. Christmas Dave, bro. Yay! But today, I'm gonna try to go head to head with the McDonald's Turtle Sundae. It's like their Christmas shit that they got going right now. Here's a picture of that. But I think I can make a way better sundae for the exact opposite price. It's gonna be way more expensive, it's gonna be way more epic, and it's gonna taste way better. I'm combining so much shit, I don't know if it's gonna taste good, but take it easy! Put your trust in Big Dick Dave! Chef Dave's got this. So, let me show you, first of all, the McDonald's Turtle Sundae. So here is your Turtles McDonald's Sundae. It looks like the regular chocolate fudge sundae that you get, and they added the little bits of turtle. It's basically good chocolate that they put on top of sundae, so like, it just gets way better. And then, it also comes with a bag of pecan pieces, or pecan pieces, I don't know how you say it. And then you sprinkle it on top, and boom, shabam, da boo, da boo, dee, dee, doo. You have your turtle sundae. My sundae that I make is about to be easily over $100. So that's a pretty big price difference. So you'd expect that the higher price sundae that I'm about to make is gonna taste way better than this garbage. Probably not. It probably tastes so good. All right, so I'm gonna put this in the freezer for the time being because I need to construct my giant epic sundae, and then we can compare both. I mean, if my sundae goes to shit, we can always just do a little sing-along Christmas jingle, you know? Let's hear them sleigh bells jingling, ding, 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 too. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with my big day. So I'm gonna use this big glass bowl to construct my sundae. The first thing I need is my base, which is the ice cream. And I got candy cane ice cream. Chocolate fudge crackle. If you told me this existed, I would have said, I say nay nay. Next up, and it was right beside the candy cane ice cream, so I was like, this is just like a match made in heaven. It's perfect. Candy cane popsicles. I mean, these are not popsicles. I think it's basically just this ice cream, but with a chocolate coating on the top. We're gonna add that as a garnish at the end. Perfect. Harry's orange chocolate. You guys probably already know about this. It's basically an orange, and it comes out like slices like this. Hold on. Come on, focus, please. There you go. And in order to get the slices, you have to take the ball, and you have to go, I have to just slam it at something hard. So like a table, my fridge, the floor, my big dick, anything hard. The next two things I found at the store, these are classics. Everyone's probably had them. Pillsbury Christmas tree cookies. We're gonna use this as a garnish as well. Or I might just like crumble them up, you know, kind of like a peanut coating, but it's a cookie coating. And these ones are actually new. Like, I've never seen these ones before. They're also Pillsbury, but they're gingerbread cookies. Candy cane Oreos. Now, I know at first glance it might sound a little disgusting. I agree with that. But come on, we can't bash it until we tried. So like, cross your fingers right now. Let's finger each other right now that it works, okay? Hot cocoa chips ahoy. Hot chocolate, man. That's amazing. A little Kinder surprise. Correct me if I'm wrong. Is this banned in the States because of like choking hazard? I don't know. But yeah, I got this little guy. I'll find something cute to do with it. I mean, yay! Are you done? How the hell am I gonna make a sundae over $100 with that little guy? Nah, we went with this big daddy. And you know this guy has a big toy inside. Kinder Surprise chocolate is so good. Have you guys tried this? If not, you're missing out. It's really good. All right, back up. Next thing I'm about to show you guys, probably the most important in my sundae because it's the most expensive, these Godiva chocolates, man. I don't understand why these are so expensive. I went to the mall yesterday. Look at this picture I took. How you tell me that box of chocolate is $95? Who the hell is spending $95 plus tax, so over $100 for a box of chocolates. Not this guy. Never in my entire life will you see me buy that box of chocolates. But thankfully, my mom had a box, so we gonna use this. But now we are moving on to the liquids, the drizzle drazzle of the sundae. Nutella, absolutely delicious. I'm gonna go in with this one. There's no holding back when it comes to chocolates here, but are you kidding me? Okay, the last four ingredients, I'm not sure how we're gonna make it work. Maybe if we just use a little bit of each, because if we overdo it, the sundae is ruined. I got eggnog, I got rich, creamy chocolate egg. Chocolate eggnog. This right here, I recently came across, and Drunk Dave is very happy about it. Rum chata. It's a Caribbean rum with real dairy cream, natural and artificial flavors. This shit right here is cinnamon toast crunch in liquid form. It has rum in it, so if you're under the drinking age, then you can't use this, but if you're over the drinking age, dog, you can fucking chug this. And then last but not least, we have sriracha, but I'm probably not gonna use it. Come on, let's be realistic. I love sriracha, but in a sundae, take it easy. This is all the ingredients right here. As you can see, I already pre-made the cookies, the gingerbread, and the Christmas tree, so we don't have to wait. So before we put everything together, let's just get a banana for scale. Look how big this banana is compared to everything else. First thing we're putting is the ice cream, the candy cane ice cream, baby. Where's the open tab? Right here. Oh shit, it's melting quick. All right, we need to get things going. We are gonna go in on this. Whoa, this looks weird. I don't know about this, guys. Look at it. This is what that candy cane ice cream looks like. Oh shit, it smells minty. Plop, one big one here. Another plop, boom. That's not enough. You know what, we're just gonna use it all. That's really good. I wouldn't say it tastes like candy cane though. Oh shit, okay. I know why it's candy cane. There's little bits of candy cane inside the ice cream. I just didn't bite into it yet. That's delicious. I approve. We're off to a great start. Candy cane Oreos right here. Let's give a little taste test. Oh, don't buy candy cane Oreos. It doesn't even taste like candy cane. It tastes like medicine, the inside, the frosting. There's no way I'm adding this shit to my sundae, so that brings our total down like $3. But we still got the Godiva, so we're good. Yay! We gotta move on, this ice cream is melting. Okay, next up, we got the hot chocolate Chips Ahoy cookies. Mm-hmm. Doesn't really taste like hot chocolate, it tastes more like just a double chocolate chunk cookie. We'll just add them around. Try to make it look pretty. Ooh, that looks good. Okay, next up we need some Nutella, a lot of it. You can never go wrong with Nutella. Use as much as you want. I'm just gonna use like this much. I'm gonna put that right on the top in the middle right here. Oh yeah, give it some volume. Don't ever waste Nutella. Mmm. Okay, next we're gonna add more cookies. We're gonna add these Christmas tree cookies that I made. Mmm. I'm gonna do the exact same thing I did with the other ones and just place them into the ice cream. These gingerbread men can also do the same thing right here. It says whack and unwrap. I'm gonna use this cable right here. Ready? One, two, three. Oh yeah. Look at this, guys. Perfect pieces, orange chocolate. We are just gonna stuff that into the ice cream. Oh my God, the ice cream is melting quick. This is looking good. Check this out. That looks like a mess. That looks so good. Godiva chocolates, the star of the show. I hope I don't have any chocolate on my mouth. Ooh. Each one of these chocolate probably costs like $5. I'm gonna put the white one right in the middle. And the other eight. The other seven, I'm gonna place around the ice cream. Like this. This one I'm not gonna throw against the window and fucking smash it. Boom. Ooh wee! The chocolate syrup, baby. We gotta go ham with this guy. We're gonna get a nice drizzle right over that Kinder Surprise. Ooh, baby. Ooh, that swirl too. Mm-mm-mm. Oh my God, doesn't that look amazing? It looks like shit. It looks so messy, but just with me, guys. Oh my God, holy man, Chef Dave just really knows what he's doing, eh? Now all we have left is these liquids right here. Let's add a little bit of each. You know what, I'm gonna make a shot of all three of this. That's good. The chocolate eggnog, let's shake her up. Okay, that's pretty good. It's more of a, like a chocolate milk with a hint of eggnog, but delicious. Boom, rum chata. Drizzle this on top of the egg. Ooh, let's go. I fucking ruined it, didn't I? To garnish it all, I got the mini candy cane stick right here. We're gonna put it, we're gonna take a knife and we're gonna just cut down the middle. And we're gonna stab the bowl, making sure it stays put because it's the garnish of the entire thing. Perfect. Perfect. And there we have it, our epic sundae. Now we can finally taste test this one compared to the McDonald's turtle sundae.
It honestly turned out better than I imagined. It looks like Dookie. I think someone in the world should definitely hire Chef Dave and start selling these at their restaurants for like over $500. Look at this little piece of shit compared to my epicness. Like, be honest with me, guys. Do you want this little cute sundae right here that McDonald's made? Or Big Dick Dave's giant sundae, like here's a banana for scale.
So I feel like I should definitely try the $3 McDonald's sundae first. Get that out of the way because I know it's gonna taste like ass.
Look at those pecans, that turtle, that ice cream. Oh man. McDonald's, you sure know how to make something look good. But Big Dick Dave, you have the same quality. Don't worry, like this looks so good too. No, it doesn't.
Why is it so perfect? Oh my god. That was good. It was like 6 out of 10. I would pick the strawberry sundae over this. The chocolate, the caramel. The strawberry sundae is my go-to. But get that shit on my face. Okay, let's take a bite. Fucking you! Oh! It's so melting! I waited too long. It's okay though, I'm not wasting this. What is that? There's a cookie in there. Let's go! That's a massive toy! Ew, oh. What is this? Okay, very cool. Not worth $10. All right, guys. Thank you so much for watching that video. My dreams about making the most delicious sundae were a little ambitious, but it was still good. It was ass. But yeah, don't try to make that. Just go buy the McDonald's sundae. It's better and it costs way less money. If you guys enjoyed that video, or if you laughed at all during the video, or if your mouth went like that, like a little bit, just even a little bit, then go down there and smash that like button using your nose. You have to use your nose. But until next time, I will see you guys very soon.